Hello and welcome to the final day of World University Games in Cyprus. We have now a very interesting event. This is the teams event in Samba. We have four teams competing, and the first teams that will enter the arena will be the team of Cyprus and the team of Kyrgyzstan. Very simple rules for this competition, as usual. Each fighter fights his opponent in his weight class, and the team that wins the most fights will be the winner of this part of the competition. Let's see who will have the honor to start, whether it will be the girls or the boys. Now, we start with the girls. That's the lowest weight class, so we are supposed to start like this. So in red, Cyprus; in blue, Kyrgyzstan. Now the fight starts, and the winner is the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. I really think that there were some problems with her opponent's leg, because you can see her limping outside the arena. So right now Kyrgyzstan 1, Cyprus 0. And we move on to the second fight of the evening. It's the same uniform, of course. Waiting for the fight to begin. The judges are not quite ready yet, and I think everything is fine right now. So we proceed with the second fight of the evening. In red, Cyprus; in blue, Kyrgyzstan. The Cypriot is trying to establish some early grips, but look how his opponent is moving around and breaking those grips. Looking for a fireman's carry. He's the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. He succeeded to reach his opponent's leg, but it was too late, and he couldn't do anything from that position. And again, nice attempt and a nice counter for Kyrgyzstan. Stood up quickly. 1 point for the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. And this was a very nice attempt. Again, 1 point for blue. This is going to be a very interesting competition. Generally, the team competitions are very interesting because everybody stays ready, and of course you can support your national team. Sometimes it's more tense than supporting just one fighter. And also it's very interesting the fact that all nations are supposed to bring full teams in competition, which is very good and very interesting for the good of Samba competitions. Looking for the position on the ground was the fighter from Cyprus. Still another very good attack, and maybe 1 point, or maybe nothing. No, nothing. No point given. Again, they are looking for their grips, and I really like the way they both move around. They don't stand still. They don't wait on grips. Good turnover for Kyrgyzstan, but he loses the position. Both of them very calm. Oh, very nice turnover, and he was going for the pin. It didn't work for him. It was a very, very nice attack for the Cypriot. And again, both of them very calm, looking for their grip, looking for their positions. Very, very good attack for the fight from Kyrgyzstan, and this is the end of the second fight. 2-0 for Kyrgyzstan right now. This was a very, very quick tap for the Cypriot, and we prepare now for our next fight. So the fighter from Cyprus, she is the winner. Her opponent didn't come to fight, and now we move forward, the fourth fight of the evening. Of course, in red Cyprus, in blue Kyrgyzstan, and I really think this is going to be a very quick victory for the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. Look at his attitude from the get-go, a four-pointer, very quick for Kyrgyzstan. It's such a difference in attitude between the two of them, and I don't know exactly why the Cypriot is not quite ready to fight right now. Now a fighter from Kyrgyzstan is looking for an ankle lock, good position, and this wakes up his opponent. He really needs to concentrate a little bit more. He started as he was asleep, but right now he seems to be awoken, and he will try to to fight as good as he can. Again, a very good grip for the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. He's looking for an ankle pick, and again a 4-point throw, and this is it. This is it. So quickly, so easy. I don't know exactly. Maybe the fighter from Cyprus didn't warm up enough. Maybe he was not ready for the fight, because you could see it from his body language. He was hesitant. He wasn't ready to fight. But of course, there are better days and worse days for each fighter. So maybe it just wasn't his day. Of course, we'll see him in future competitions, and we wish him all the best. We start another fight. Man under 74 kilograms. The Cypriot is very calm, but he's a little bit dominated by his opponent's grips. Very strong grip on the lapel for the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. Very, very strong. And he can control the entire body of his opponent with that grip. The Cypriot really needs to move around and to break that grip. It's very difficult to be static and to try to control the grip in that particular position. Good attempt, very good attempt, very tricky one. No points, just one point scored for the Cypriot, and it's good. Looking for the grips are both of them. Let's see, and again the same lapel grip for the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. The same head control, but it's so obvious what he wants to do. He has a few techniques available from that position. He tried one of them. Didn't work. Let's see the ground now. They don't work the ground. And again, the same technique. It doesn't work. He's trying to attack the other leg, and again, but he doesn't have enough power to secure his technique. Not a bad attempt though. Anyway, we have Kyrgyzstan in the final. Regardless of the outcome of this fight, he tries again and he turns to an ankle pick. It didn't work. It didn't work, and he saw that. He has a very good grip on the lapel, a very good sleeve lapel, but he cannot move his opponent, and he cannot attack only with that technique. This is why he changed. This is why he tried to toss him, and then he tried to ankle pick him. It didn't work. But finally he understood that he has some other options, and maybe right now he will try to change a little bit the technique. There were a few attentive attacks, but really nothing happens. It's They're looking for the grapes, both of them. And we're going to see the same attack from the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. He has the same position, the same technique. It didn't work. He tries on the outside leg, on the inside leg, and it works. Finally, it works for a four-pointer. Yes, this means to be consequent. This means to keep on doing what you do best, to believe in yourself, and it finally worked. Very good pin for Kyrgyzstan, because right now he doesn't fight for himself, he fight for his country, and this is his opportunity for an arm lock. He loses it, but anyway, 8 points for Kyrgyzstan in this fight. A four-pointer, the hip toss, and then the pinning. It really worked very well for him. Another warning for Cyprus, and it was 1 point for him before, for two warnings against the fighter from Kyrgyzstan. But it's really impossible to win this fight. He has the leg, he will look for submission, nothing happens, but anyway, it's 8-2 for Kyrgyzstan, so this is a nice victory for Kyrgyzstan. And they are right now the winners of the first semifinal. So Kyrgyzstan moves on with 4-1. We are waiting now for the third and the fourth team to appear on the arena. There were some good fights, especially this last one. I really like the way the fighter from Kyrgyzstan waited and let his opponent be more and more tired, and then he threw him, and then he pinned him, and then he succeeded to control the fight. Actually, the last minute of the fight was his moment, but he fought very well, and he knew exactly what to do. He didn't get tired. Sometimes it's very important to be in peak shape in order to be able to fight as you want. And right now we move forward. Our next semi-final. This is going to be the second semi-final, Russia against Lithuania. There are a lot of interesting fights here. A lot of good technicians in both teams. So in red is Lithuania, in blue is Russia. So, let's prepare for our first fight. Let's see who will start. So the first fight will be the ladies' fight the Lithuanian, in blue is the Russian, and the fight starts. Let's see. Good position for the Russian. She's looking for the throw, but she's countered very, very well. Again, the Lithuanian looking for the lapel grip. Russian moves very well and looks for some interesting techniques. For the moment, nothing happens, just the first warning for the Lithuanian, and we are ready to go further. Oh, this was a nice one. An eye poke, an intentional eye poke, but they can go on. Very relaxed are both of them. Good attack for the Lithuanian with a single leg and the follow-up, but now the Russian has her back. Let's see, this is a good position. She has to turn, yes, very, very, very nicely done. And now she attacks the legs. This is beautiful. What a beautiful combination. Let's see, she has the leg, but she cannot extend it the way she wants it. Good defense for Lithuanian. Repeskaitė August is her name, the Lithuanian. And the Russian is Elzira Usyaeva. But that combination was very, very nice, because in a turnover, generally the fighters tend to hook the opponent's legs, and this is why you are not in a good position for the arm lock. But you also can attack the leg. But now the Russian has the arm. Let's see. Yes, she tapped. So it's a quick victory for Russia with an arm lock. Elzira Kusyaeva won by arm lock. But it was a very nice fight, a very technical fight, and I really like the way this young lady attacks the submission holds. Look how beautifully she changed the position. She went to one direction and then she turned into a 45 degrees movement in order to secure that arm lock. It worked perfectly for her. And right now, men under 74 kilograms from Russia in blue, Sergei Karopkin, and his opponent Marcin Dubovsky from Lithuania. Still very calm, both of them looking for the positions. The Russian controls the back of his opponent, is very, very calm. And they are still looking, still trying to get their favorite grips. The Russian seems to be a little bit more powerful, and he's going for the fireman carry. Nothing given, and now the Russian has the leg. Let's see It was a very good ankle lock and still holds onto the ankle lock. And another submission hold. Another submission hold victory for Russia. This guy, Karopkin, is a very, very good sambo player. He's very dangerous. We saw him yesterday with a lot of interesting techniques. He's powerful, he's fluid, he is very, very technical. It's really very interesting to watch him. And again, we see the turnover with the position. He has the leg, and this is it. This is a very nice victory for Russia. 2-0 right now for Russia, and we move forward with another fight. This is -90 kilograms, even though they seem to be a little bit smaller. Simonaitis Aivaras from Lithuania, and his opponent from Russia. But right now we have a very good another submission hold. I didn't even have the time to name the winner of this fight, but I'll do it right now. Ivan Pakhmonov from Russia, he wins another nice victory with the submission hold. This seems to be the specialty for the Russian team tonight. It's 3-0 right now for Russia. Look how beautifully and how tight he goes for that ankle lock. Great positioning and very calm execution for the Russian. Okay, let's move forward. Lekavičius Zivinas from Lithuania against the Russian Dmitry Eliseyev. Also, we saw Eliseyev yesterday with a very good fight in the finals. He's looking for unbalancing his opponent, the Lithuanian. He's still holding those defensive grips. But the first warning goes to the Russian. And now we restart. The Russian looking for his grips. Good double leg attempt for the Lithuanian, but it was stopped early. And he also receives the warning. Nice lapel grip for the Russian, who is going for a hip toss. Nice throw, but it didn't work, and now he's looking for the arm lock. But we all knew what he was going to do, even Lekavičius knew. So this is why he defended so well. 1 point for the Russian due to a second deduction for the Lithuanian. Another outside attack for the Russian. He has the back. He's looking for the arm. Let's see. He tries to turn over his opponent. He has the arm. He doesn't have to turn it over. He just has to secure that arm. The position is very good. The tension is good. Yes, he has the arm, and this is it. This is it. Another submission victory for Russia. Actually, I think it's very interesting the fact that all these fights were won by submission holds. Dmitry Eliseyev is the winner of this final. And Russia moves forward into the final, where they will fight against Kyrgyzstan. Yeah, it was very interesting. They won all their fights by submission holds. They didn't look for a huge throw. They didn't look for so for something spectacular. They were just very effective, and they knew exactly what they have to do. Minimum effort, in a way, and a lot of technique, and a great victory. And we can see the strategy here. They didn't want to be very tired in the finals. They wanted to win quickly, to win in a very technical manner, in order to be fresh for the finals. And this is a good strategy, in my opinion. Let's see what they can do against the team of Kyrgyzstan, who also displayed a very beautiful sambo in their first semifinal.
Флеш будет, флешмоб будет снимать, а мне нельзя лицо светить.